We have a very rich, highly productive agricultural system that requires drainage. We know that those drainage systems can have some negative impacts. Those negative impacts can be related to nutrient losses like nitrogen, phosphorus, and sediment. And so we're really trying to look at how can we establish practices that farmers can adopt in order to minimize some of those losses.
I think one of the big priority areas that we continue to want to see researchers look at was how can we really combine the efforts of water quality and water quantity and answer, can we really get some good nutrient reductions and then giving us things that can benefit both farmers and the environment.
And we're able to try to accomplish that by not looking at single, simple focused research here in Southwest Minnesota, but more integrated, holistic kinds of an approach where we're looking at individual practices, but then as we move up into this watershed scale, we're starting to try to look at all of those practices together and trying to see what's the best that we can do within our watershed.
I think they really hit it out of the park by saying, hey, we have this great research station. We have different practices here that we're doing, but we've never really looked at the effect of saying, if we combine together the cover crops, the wetlands, the bioreactor, and the drainage ditches, if we combine all these together, what's the effects at the end? What are we really seeing, and how is that really affecting water quality in the end?